Hello and welcome to Tech Deals. Are you looking for the best value in a $1,000 gaming laptop computer? Do you want to play all current games 1080p, high detail or better, 60 frames per second or better, with options for expandability in the future? You have come to the right place. For $1,000, this is an amazing value for the money. i7-7700HQ processor. It's the high-performance 4-core 8-thread chip, up to 3.8 gigahertz clock speed. It's got 16 gigabytes of system RAM already installed, more than enough for all current games on the market and multitasking. 256 gigabyte solid state boot drive. This thing boots in under 10 seconds flat from a cold boot to the Windows desktop. It comes with Wi-Fi, webcam, a 1080p IPS display, and all the other features that you'd expect from a modern high-end gaming laptop. Most importantly, NVIDIA's GeForce GTX 1060 6GB card. This is not a mobile cutdown chip. It is the full desktop processor, same as you'd get in a gaming desktop computer. It also runs at nearly full clock speed. It's currently running the Heaven benchmark at 1911 MHz on the graphics chip. That is really, really good. So if you want to play games and you want performance, but you want a laptop computer, you've come to the right place. Linked down in the video description below are going to be a couple of things. First, there's a link over to Tech Deals Gaming. I've done a number of game performance videos on this full screen showing the live gameplay, not just built-in benchmarks. If you want to see a bunch of games tested on this, go check that link out. It'll bring up the entire list of games. You can click on the specific games that you want to watch and see how well this performs. Later in this video, I'm going to have a bunch of benchmark charts where I show you built-in benchmarks as well as non-gaming benchmarks. We'll talk about that in a minute. But I would also like to point out that the link to Amazon.com where I bought this laptop, it was not a sample from Acer, I did pay for this with my own money. A link to Amazon down below where you can check this out is down there as well. That is an affiliate link, it does support the channel. If you like this review and my content in general, please use that when shopping, I'd be greatly appreciative. Simply put, for $1,000, this is one of the best values for the money you'll find in a gaming laptop, or frankly, any laptop computer on the market today. You can, please note, get faster and more well-equipped machines than this if you spend more money. Do you have $1,500 to spend? You can get a laptop with a hard drive and an SSD and a GTX 1070 and possibly a slightly higher clocked version of this CPU. No worries. Do you have $2,000 to spend? 4K touchscreen displays are totally possible at that price point. But if you've got $1,000 to spend and you want to get the most for the least amount of money spent, this is the sweet spot of price to performance. When you go below this laptop, you start cutting off a lot of performance to save just a little bit of money. The $800 versions of these laptops generally tend to come with GTX 1050 graphics card. You lose half of the graphics performance to save 20% of the money. They also often come with 8 gigs of RAM instead of 16. Some of them do not even come with a solid state drive. Some of them do not have IPS displays, the rich color and the wide viewing angles of this. So yes, you can save a couple $100s, but you give up a lot to get there. Now, if you don't care about playing the latest and greatest AAA games, if you're like, well, I just want to play Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Overwatch, and League of Legends, do you have to spend $1,000? No, you don't. A $600 budget laptop will absolutely do that. I've got one to review. It's got one of the U low-power CPUs in it and the MX-150. It's $400 less than this. And if you're only interested in casual or esports gaming, that sort of machine may be more up your alley. But if you've got the money, this is double the performance of the $600 to $800 budget machines for less than double the price. And it's got room to add. I've already put a 2 terabyte hard drive in here. It comes with only the SSD. So you're going to want to budget about $90 to add a 2 terabyte hard drive if you want to add more storage for games, because 256 doesn't go very far. But you don't need to add more RAM because it comes with 16. And frankly, otherwise, it's pretty much perfect out of the box. In addition to the features I just mentioned, there are two USB 2 ports on this side. There are two USB 3.1 ports on that side, one of which is a Type-C. The HDMI and the RJ45 Ethernet port are on that side, as well as a memory card reader. The Kensington lock is on that side. The power connector is over here, as well as the headphone connector. Now, the keyboard is backlit, as you can see. Red is your only color. It's not RGB. It can be turned on and off. You don't have to have it backlit if you don't want. And it's got a recessed trackpad in the front. Now, what do I think of the trackpad and the keyboard? They're fine. I'm not ecstatic about them. It's a very short throw, chiclet style keyboard. The travel on the keys is not great. But then frankly, I don't like any laptop keyboards these days. I have not actually used a laptop keyboard in probably 10 years that I really liked. So they all kind of equally are terrible in my viewpoint. I like full-size keyboards, and so I generally try to use an external keyboard whenever possible. Same thing with wireless mice. I find trackpads in general to be pretty bad, so I usually use external mice when I use them. In the limited amount of time that I've used this, it's fine, not great. You're getting a lot of value in terms of hardware. Don't expect the world when it comes to the keyboard and the trackpad. Beyond the keyboard and the trackpad being average, so to speak, the other two things about this laptop that I don't care for are, one, the material it's made out of, because it's that black plastic that catches every fingerprint smudge on earth. If your goal is to keep a pristine looking laptop that doesn't have any handprint smudges or those oily prints from where you touched it, yeah, it's not going to be this one. I have wiped this down and wiped this down to try to make it look nice for this film. Every area around the keyboard, even the lid of this thing, it's just smudge city. So just be aware of the fact that 5 minutes after you open and start using this thing, it's not going to look pristine anymore. The other issue is fan noise and heat. This laptop gets quite warm. Now, it does not thermally throttle. I actually have it installed on a cooling pad at the moment, but the cooling pad is not running at the moment. The temperature of the laptop drops up to 4 degrees Celsius when the cooling pad is running, but there's no performance difference. I've benchmarked it both ways. There will be separate reviews of cooling pads coming up soon, but I've already tested 3 different ones. This laptop does not thermal throttle. It just runs cooler when it's on a pad. If you game on your lap, if you have the laptop actually on your lap, you're gonna need something to put it on or you will burn your lap. The bottom of this thing gets very, very hot. On a desk, it's absolutely fine, no issue. Sound is a different topic. It's loud. It's not loud when you're just in Windows. If you're browsing the web, watching videos such as this, checking your email, doing Facebook, Twitter, etc., this machine is silent as a mouse. The minute you start gaming and using that graphics chip, it's loud enough that I'd want to be using headphones. I would not recommend trying to game using the built-in speakers. The sound of the fan is very overpowering. All of the heat from this laptop, by the way, comes out of the back. Out of the left-hand side of the back of the laptop. It's warm, but not too hot, so be aware that you gotta leave room behind the laptop for that heat to come out when you're gaming. Regarding expansion choices, there's one. There's a 2.5-inch drive bay on the bottom. The tray is included, but no screws are in there. No big deal for an SSD, but you'll want drive screws for a hard drive if you put a hard drive in there. I currently have a 2 TB hard drive installed, but an SSD would also fit just fine. If you want more space for your games, drop a drive in. Now, as far as RAM goes, both memory slots are populated. It's got 16 gigs already installed. To go to 32 would require taking out the existing RAM. That makes no economic sense. If you want 32 gigs of RAM, buy a laptop that already has it. This would not be the right choice. Everything else, well, frankly, is what you already need, which is that i7 CPU and the GTX 1060. For $1,000, it's a lot of value for the money. Now, regarding benchmarks, throughout this video, I've been putting some of them up here above the laptop to try to keep the length of this video shorter, but I'm now gonna go full screen and show you the minimum, maximum, and average game performance numbers of 9 different games that I've tested. Please note that these results are different than the standalone game performance videos done over on Tech Deals Gaming. Those are live gameplay videos where I actually tested the game while playing the game. The 9 games that I'm showing you here were all tested in the game's built-in benchmark, so these results are unique and different from what's over on Tech Deals Gaming. The key point that I'd like you to notice is that the average frame rate of all the games except Mankind Divided is over 60 frames per second. It is well known that Mankind Divided's benchmark is brutally difficult. The game actually runs better than the benchmark, believe it or not. So putting that one issue aside, the rest of them run very, very well. To be honest, this machine performs spectacularly well for what it costs and what it is for a portable 6-pound laptop. This is great, great performance. You should easily get 2 years of solid AAA gaming performance out of this, and even longer for esports and casual gaming before you need to do another upgrade. The fact that Nvidia has squeezed a full-size GTX 1060 graphics card into a laptop is nothing short of remarkable. I highly encourage you to download the free benchmarks and try them yourself on your own machine. 7-Zip's built-in benchmarks, CPU-Z, Cinebench are all free benchmarks you can download yourself. Not all of them are, but many of them are. Try them on your current machine. If the performance is half the speed of this, that'll give you an idea of what to expect. If it's 75%, so on, is it worth upgrading? The question is it worth upgrading is a highly personal question. I can't tell you if it's worth upgrading to you because I don't know your financial situation. But what I will say is if you want an extremely powerful gaming machine that can multitask and do all sorts of things, you can edit video on this thing. You could run a YouTube channel, frankly, if you wanted to. You can live stream to Twitch with this. It's a lot of computer in a very small portable 6-pound package. Like this video if you like it, share it with your friends if you loved it, remember to subscribe to my channel with that big huge red button directly below, questions and comments in the comment section, and as always, check the links in the video description. The link to buy this on Amazon, where I bought this, and you should too if you want the best deal on a $1,000 gaming laptop computer. The link to Tech Deals Gaming for the full playlist of games on this laptop will also be down there as well. This thing is a beast. Go check out Players Unknown Battlegrounds, Ghost Recon Wildland, GTA 5. Yes, I know those two were in this as well, but these were built-in benchmarks. Those are live gameplay, and you can see the games being played. Assassin's Creed Syndicate and others are down there. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video.